Hey guys, my name's Jamie. Welcome back to Clipping Error for another, it's been a while, taking a look at video. Now with Metal Gear, whatever the hell it's called, Phantom Pain, that's the one, coming out pretty soon, I figured it'd be good to check out Peace Walker, which is basically the spiritual prequel. I mean, it's the original. Phantom Pain is like the spiritual successor to this game. I never finished this game, but it's pretty cool. It's got all the kind of base building mechanics. You can't walk around your mother base, but it's still there. It's the base that gets destroyed. Spoilers, gets destroyed at the end of Ground Zeroes. So we're going to hop in, give you a quick look. Depending on how far I can get into this. This game, your player name. Okay. Jay. Done. Yep, that name is absolutely fine. Basically... Oh, okay. So action button, switch, aim button, attack is R1, shoot type, zoom, action button, zoom, zoom, crouch. Yeah, I mean, that's fine. Select button, equip, unequip. Yep. That all seems fine to me. Okay, good. We're good. New save. I didn't know if it was going to go jump straight into the game, so we're just going through. So yeah, this game came out for PSP originally, PlayStation Portable, not the PlayStation Vita, and then this is the HD remake, remaster. It's set directly after Metal Gear Solid 3. Also after Portable Ops, which nobody really cared about. I loved Portable Ops with a passion. The problem with Portable Ops was you had to recruit people by knocking them out and like bringing them back, like actually physically hauling them across the floor to a van, and sometimes you had to do that across a whole level. This is where the Fulton recovery thing was introduced, and I don't think I can skip this cutscene. Unfortunately, it's got some pretty cool comic book art style stuff, as well as, you know, the graphics. It's really cool. I really liked the idea of this game. I was kind of burnt out a bit from the base management stuff that's in Portable Ops, and that game in itself is just another beast. So it's a snake, naked snake. After whatever, really, I can't remember what happened. Basically, he got really pissed off with the whole Patriot situation and decided to make his own army. And people followed him because he's the boss. So this is just a training montage of all of his troops. And they're just beating the crap out of each other using CQC. This is where CQC really became a proper thing. It's all about like snakes fighting style.
Boss!
Oh yeah, and it's worth saying David Hayter was in this game. He's not Snake in the late, going into Ground Zeroes or the Phantom Pain.
Hey, boss!
That, in fact,
wanna
is
go around?
Kiefer Sutherland. Okay, so walk up to him. So this is like, this is where Crouch Walk came in as well. So I should just be able to beat the sugar out of him. There he goes, he's down.
Look alive, ladies! The boss is gonna join us! Show them how it's done, boss! Your first priority in enemy territory is knowing your surroundings. Your life depends on where you are looking and how fast you can identify your targets. Therefore, you must first master moving your line of sight. To move your line of sight, use the right stick. Now, when I give you an order, look in that direction. Look up! Good! Look down!
Oh god, we're ending this tutorial. I'm not doing this goddamn tutorial. It's too easy. Like, it's really easy to pick up. It's just Metal Gear. But, what happens now? What's he doing? He's gonna beat the crap out of one of them?
What's going on?
Oh, no, here's this.
We've got guests.
Time to move.
Don't worry, it's not our friends from Langley. I brought him, made sure we won't follow.
Thank you, Big Boss.
Call me Snake.
Sorry, Big Boss.
Listen up. For us, there is no victory.
But in revolution, doesn't one triumph or die?
We don't do either.
Guy's so confused. Poor guy. Yeah, we don't really need to. We don't need to watch these cutscenes because the whole point of this is to show you. So there's a lot of exposition. This is classic Kojima stuff. But tons of just cutscenes and cutscenes and information. Lots of stuff going on. And I'll be honest, you don't need to. You don't need to know it all for this overview of the game. What I'm doing here, you don't need to know it all. I might do a playthrough maybe later at some point, you know. Probably not anytime soon.
Miller,
but like,
oh
yeah, right,
Snake.
So you've got,
I see you've landed
top
that
right corner. Oh god,
I'm sending this
so
from
loud.
The offshore plant, our mother base. The signal is unidirectional. I'll
mother base, yeah, there you go.
This channel, keep your headphones
so
on
here we
at
go
all times
to pick up
pay attention.
A grenade.
Also,
yep.
Make sure no one else can listen in. Snake, are you clear on the controls? Take a minute to refresh your memory.
Rations.
Use the left stick.
Yeah,
to
we
move.
Want the sound indicator. So
use
the sound
the
indicator
right
is always equipped.
Now
you've got this troop. You've got your gun to view.
To change your settings,
so what Portable Ops had was an actual ring around Snake. No radar, like you've got the top
there's
right
no
there.
Around.
An actual ring that made the
practice.
Noise thing.
Select a target and squeeze off a round or two. Press the directional button.
Squeeze off around.
The R2
bam.
Button to switch weapons.
Bam.
Ready your weapon with the L1 button.
And then,
reload. Press the R1 button to fire.
Good. This game
how
actually looks phenomenally
shooting
good.
Practice. Try hitting a coconut.
What? Oh. What?
Select equipment
so
by pressing
coconut.
The square or circle button while
oh,
holding
can
the
you get food in this game?
To check
no, you
your
can't.
Map.
I thought you get food. Got really excited then. Oh no, it's the hero I've got to go. Okay. I was trying to.
Rifle, capable of
rapid trying to be
fire.
Clever.
The facility you're headed for is past that fence. A grenade should be able to take out that gate.
Oh, I've got to use a grenade. Okay. So let's equip grenade.
Snake. Use the L1 button.
Fire
to ready
a grenade off.
Weapons.
Yes, you've got this little aiming reticule thing
throw
going on
the
there.
R1 button. When using throwing weapon,
bam.
Hold the attack button down
easy.
Longer to throw farther.
Whoa.
You won't throw the weapon
a stun
until
rod?
You let go
oh my
the
god.
The
yeah,
Mark
we want the Mark 22 out. You wanna trank some people and then send them back to your base.
I gotta thank you for agreeing to this, Snake. Man, am I glad to be out of here. Finally, we can leave all that crap in San Jeronimo behind. Break into the mercenary business for real.
Don't really know what they're talking about. This is basically setting up everything for them having a mother base. And there's quite a lot. Oh, Christ, come on. So much cutscene. It kind of shows you that this is a true Kojima game. It's really very good, though. And at the time, for a portable experience, it was just fantastic. It was great. Am I actually in the jungle again now? It came like pretty soon after on the heels of
this is a sneaking
3.
Mission. Hide behind stuff. Take the long way around. Whatever it takes.
Hide
stay
behind
outside.
Stuff. Thanks,
your
Miller.
Your gun is a last resort. It could just as easily kill you as save you.
Bam. Okay, he's out. Sorry, I was just trying
to
find a button if there
wall.
Was a
face it and hit the action button. From that position, you can
right,
press the L1 button to detect enemies. That also
oh.
works while lying down.
Yeah, get stuff out of them, okay.
Room, huh? We'll keep
oh,
it
crap.
Here at the base.
No, 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 stay asleep, stay asleep. Do I not have a Fulton? Oh, I don't have the Fulton on me, okay. Okay, there's a guy up there.
The indicator in the upper right serves as a compass and shows sound sources. Pay attention to your surroundings.
Oh, right, yeah, so if you kind of... Oh, it's not really showing it.
Unfortunately, you can't crawl this time around.
What? Why can't you crawl?
So if this guy was walking,
it would be flashing up.
The more easily you'll be spotted.
That he's making a bit of noise.
And loud noises will compromise your camo index. Your fatigue.
That, yeah, that would like Camilla's saying here. He's that would compromise his position, just like it would compromise my position if I start running about. So you've got to stay crouched, basically. You can get stuff out of them, which is good because you can equip it for other missions. So it's always worth it. Plus, it's like the quick... It's the quick way to... Oh, what the hell? Made him freeze. Bam! Go to sleep. I don't think there are dog tags in this. I love the way Snake looks when he reloads as well. Such a douchebag. Right. Oh. So I'm gonna sneak up on this guy. Bam! CQC slammed him.
When you clear the jungle,
okay, he's down.
You'll be there. Head east.
Okay, I'm just gonna leave him to it. Yeah, so this was very much kind of, you have a goal, and it's like the whole map of Peace Walker was long. It was a really long one, instead of it being an area that you kind of, you know, Dark Souls style or... I don't know, like the first Metal Gear where you go back on yourself a lot, or like Big Shell where you went back on yourself, you went to other areas, and they all kind of interlinked and you were a bit freer to walk around them. In this, it's very much like you're free to walk around all the areas and stuff, but it's very much just a big long map, and you will go to... I'm not moving because there's a guy there. You will go to different places...
Looks
within
like you're
the same map.
Security is tight. Stay sharp.
Hideo Kojima's name pops up there. Bam! Oh crap. Bam. Oh good. Got him just in time. So my silencer is actually wearing down pretty fast. There's a guy there. I'm just going to sneak. I'm going to try. Oh, I've got a stun rod, so I could use that. Yeah, so look at the radar and how it's working. So it's the colours and the sound vibrations basically mean that someone's coming close to you, and you don't want to be doing a lot while they're close to you, damn it. Because, well, they'll just, you know, spot you. Shot him in the crotch. I don't know why what I just tried to do didn't work. Stun rod. Oh, there we go. And that knocks him out a bit better than CQC slamming him. Alright, then we got a guard up there. Which we really want to get past. Might just... crotch shocked. Oh, crap. Okay, he's
who's out there?
Distracted. Shocked. Okay, this is not how to play Peace Walker, to be honest. Two shots. Christ, mate, stay down. Jesus. Just don't get back up. Okay, he's out. Good. Flipping heck. And then I think I have to go in here to get inside it. Yeah. Mission complete. So you're just, like, running around there, investigating stuff. This is, like you've landed, you're exploring. You uncover some stuff. I'm gonna try. Oh, you
yes,
can't
sir,
skip.
We broke them. We acquired the whereabouts of target 500.
Acknowledged. Spears are loaded. The barge is cleared. Point Bravo.
Acknowledged. Al.
You can't skip it. That's kind of crap. Oh, R1. I've got it. Like, there's like cutscenes. No crap. It's QTEs. I forgot about these. In fact, I'm not even sure they were in the other one.
The cargo. Where's it headed? What is it?
Irsu! In the mountains!
What's up there?
R1. No. Oh, okay. Smash him. Oh yeah, this is that, like, this is the AI, which is like smarter than anything that's ever existed. And it sings to itself, which is really odd. I can skip now. Okay, cool. I want to show you as much gameplay as possible as I can in this little, like, from the beginning overview. See if we can do a mission proper. Oh yeah, and you get graded on all your stuff. Stunrod rank 1. Cool. Sweet. Rank A, next. Can now be infused with the heroic spirit here. Okay. M1C rank 1. Okay. Smoke grenade rank 1. Yeah, yeah. So that's stuff you can develop in your, like, your research bit at Mother Base. You need to have enough people there to kind of work with that, though. You need decent research people who are going to be able to actually research the stuff you want them to. There's your Mother Base. So, you've got, if we go over to here, oh no, that's not what I wanted at all, that's mission selector, so you can go, no, so you can assign people to different areas, combat unit R&D team, so at the moment I've got no one, so everyone's in the waiting room waiting for everything, and they've all got very specific skills, so this guy, I want to assign him to, oh crap, he was R&D, yeah. And immediately, like, development costs that. Yeah, okay. Okay, and immediately you unlock stuff. So, and his skill is definitely in R&D as well. So I'm going to stick him in R&D. He's got improved R&D skill. He's good at R&D. He's good at R&D. Most of these guys are brilliant at R&D. This guy's got slight affinity there for medicine, actually. But I'm not going to put him there. He's combat unit. He is definitely medicine, but there doesn't seem to be... Can't really put anyone in there yet. So, combat unit. Combat unit. Combat unit. He's better at food. So he needs to stay here for now. Better at medicine. Better at food. Miller is amazing at R&D, so he's going to overshoot that, which is good. And we don't... Oh, it doesn't look like we've got any... Yeah, so people go in the brig for a time, and then they'll get unlocked once they've been beaten up a bit. Beaten into submission. Moonwass. I love the names of these. So, I don't know if I'm supposed to assign all of these guys. I don't particularly want to just assign them anywhere, but I will. The R&D team look like they're doing alright for now. Details, No, that's not what I want. Right, so that's just people. And then we go on a mission selector. And this is where we will be able to... Oh, yeah, you could do co-op ops, but, you know. I never did any of the co-op ops, actually. Yeah. So, just main ops, extra ops, fault in recovery. Snake has knocked out a radar soldier supply facility. Use Fulton to recover him. Contact. So do you know what? Actually, we could... Yeah, we could do that Fulton recovery just to give you an idea. Let's do this, and then you can... Oh, yeah, skip. Okay, so you can see it. So you get this, then you go to mission prep, and you want to choose the outfit. And I... had. Yeah, I don't have it here now. We're gonna go white. Oh, no. We're in the kind of like... Red? Yellow. Survival. I want to say yellow. And you can choose the guns. That'll be fine. Love box. Fulton recovery system. And that's fine. That's all your stuff. That's briefing files if you want to get more into it. Snake is not available on this mission. What? Oh. Oh, okay. So I'll have to... Well, I'm using Alligator because he's the next best guy. And he's going out in yellow then.
Survival.
Yeah, fine. And then we'll start the mission. So, yeah, that's the other thing in this. Much like in The Phantom Pain, you can play as your other... soldiers, the ones you Fulton recovery, you can play as. That's where I need to get to.
Use Fulton recovery to bring back knocked out soldiers. To use Fulton recovery on a soldier, get up next to them so the icon appears and push the action button.
This guy will pass out in a second.
I know I saw something.
That's too tall to climb. If only you had some equipment.
What? Oh, maybe that was a hint. What? I shot this guy. Why hasn't he passed out yet? There we go. He's down. And this is a really terrible idea, using yellow. How many of these do we have? 9. Okay, so what we can do here... Yeah, there he goes. So now he'll be in my brig, and you can do up to 9 of these. You can also do more of these at a time, just to get, you know, as many soldiers as possible. It's actually, like, it's so much fun just going around trying to capture soldiers. I love it. Probably one of the better bits about this game. I just love it. I love it so much. Fulton, and you don't need the radar, or you don't need it much, you just need to be aware of your surroundings. I know this guy there.
Fulton recovery, your helicopter is complete.
Yeah, he's looking at me. So, what Miller was saying earlier, you know, pity you don't have some equipment. You need to get, through R&D, you need to get more equipment to basically... be able to, what am I trying to say, be able to do more stuff, and that's the same, like, today, loads of, like, this will probably go out tomorrow, so yesterday, loads of Phantom Pain reviews came out, and it's all about this new stuff, like, it's not new, it's just a refined version of this, that's all, and then you get to the end, it's, that's all the Phantom Pain is, it's just a refined version of Peace Walker, and the idea is presented in Peace Walker and Portable Ops. With the possible exception of the multiplayer from Portable Ops, which was fantastic for PSP, but, you know, wasn't the best. Maybe I'll do a video on that at some point as well. I'll show you. Sorry, you can now do through that through any mission. As you knock guards out, as you stun them, you can just, bam, we're going to go to Mother Base. Oh, crap. No, mission selector. No, didn't mean to do that. You can get your Fulton out. You've got 9 at the moment. You can upgrade that to be more. It is totally up to you. Yeah, I wanna go to Mother Base because I want to show you what's going on in Mother Base now I've captured 4 soldiers. It's quite interesting. Or at least, you know. So here, they pop up. Alligator, because he went on that mission, he gained experience. You've got 4 new members in your unit. So you go in here. Alright, you go to the brig. Oh, they're not even there. Oh, okay. So they're all here. Wow, he's going straight to the R&D team. He needs to get some medicine, really, but I don't have a medicine ward. They all need to go to the medicine ward, really. Like, none of these guys, with the exception of a few, are going to be any good in that area. In either of those areas, really. So, cool, now we'll go to the... Oh, hang on. Staff versus ops, okay. R&D, sorry, no. So here you can choose stuff to develop. So you can choose where your team focuses their development work. So you can go like, I want this gun. You can say, I want you to upgrade the Mark 22, rank 1. In fact, I don't think I can because it's already there. So actually, oh, sorry, there's rank 2. So I can say, do rank 2. Yep, develop it, and that'll take an amount of time. And then you've got a directional mic there and all that kind of stuff. Mic might be good. Yep. What I want them to do is focus on the Fulton. Oh, but I can't unlock that yet. Analyzer, that'll work. Do that. Just kind of get them working on loads of stuff. And then that should, as we go through, build up, and you'll unlock more stuff through missions. You just unlock them as you play, because your team is working behind you to bolster your arsenal. Okay, then we'll do this. We'll do this mission. Skip that crap. Single player, so this one you could do with 2 of you. Do mission prep, do snake. We're in the jungle, so I'll be honest, we're going to go green. Or maybe not. No, we're going to go tree bark. He's got Fulton recovery system. Can he have another gun on him? No, I'm not really going to use any of these. So let's just start the mission. We'll jump straight in. So basically, Snake's going from Mother Base out like he would in the Phantom Pain. Very much a similar setup. Basically exactly the same setup going on here as you have in the Phantom Pain, except the Phantom Pain looks much, much prettier. Okay, we're straight in. Got a guard ahead of us, so what I will do is equip sound indicator for now, because you don't really need the Fulton.
You can use the radio you just picked up by pressing the start button to open the menu window. You know you can assign the radio to the select button by choosing options from the menu window.
Okay, so I knocked him down while his mate wasn't looking. Bam, took him out. Okay. And then we will quickly Fulton this guy out. And this guy. So you want to Fulton out pretty much as many people as you can. Because they will bolster your mother base with men. And you can never, never have too many people in your area. So that's the map of where you've got to go. So now I'm in the Ravine area. And this game has everything. It has crazy bosses. It has stupid things you can go and find and unlock. It's just kind of like it was Metal Gear like it had always needed to be. Portabilized. It's pretty what I mean. Oh, yeah, and there you go. So now, well, I mean, it's a little less kind of... That was an attraction to Metal Gear in, like, Metal Gear 3. You know, you didn't have enough space. your gear, you know, you had to leave it or you had to like eat something, like make sure you, Metal Gear 3 in particular, you had to make sure you ate the food before it went rotten. Here, it just gets sent to Mother Base. Probably going to be exactly the same in the Phantom Pain, I'll be honest. But the environments in this game, like, for the time, this game looked great. Like, this was originally on PSP. Pretty much looked like this, just not HD. And it looks pretty good. Yeah. Like, all credit to it. Nailed him in the head, okay. I want to have the sound indicator out, because I don't trust these guys. So you can still aim. This guy I'm going to take out with my fists, however. Or with my stun rod.
What's going on? Rise and shine.
Press the attack button near the enemy to initiate close
combat.
No
rise and shine, mate. Alright, well, while they're passed out. Oh, crap. Just gonna fault and recovery this guy. So that's immediately three more people. I don't know if there were crocodiles in this game. Can I swim? No, I can't swim. Damn it. No, that was a really good thing in 3. Alright, let's get this back out because we're going into the target area. If I'd paid attention to what the hell the mission objective was here, I'd probably be able to show you, sort of tell you that I need to kidnap the guy instead
by.
Of
neutralize
oh, crap.
The security detail and make contact
instead
with
of
the commandante.
Killing. Oh no, it's okay, so I need to contact someone. Right. Yeah, so this is definitely more like sneaking. Okay, I've got a bit of cover over there. Oh crap, no, I can't move. If this guy spots me. Problem is, this game, much like the Phantom Pain, it can escalate extremely quickly. You get in the way, someone sees you, and before you know it, you've got, like, SEAL Team 7 on your butt. Pop. Okay, he's down. Whoa.
I think I see someone.
Okay, so this guy thought he saw me. Shock in the balls. Shock. Okay, I need to actually wait for him to stop struggling. Stop struggling. Get down. This is good because it's quite a secluded area. Now, I could leave him if I wanted to. The way it is, I want to evacuate as many people as I can. I feel like I'm going to have to take that guy out.
Fulton recovery helicopter is complete.
I might be able to get him with the stun rod, actually. Oh, yeah, and you can switch between your last two most used weapons there. I'm going to take a risk. Yeah, he didn't see me. Oh, crap, there's another guy there. This is the risk you take when you walk around. Oh crap, he's gonna see that guy. Okay. Okay, he's down. It's good. Okay, we're golden if I can just Fulton him. Okay. Whoop. Okay, snuck by that guy. Fulton this guy. Yep, this is where the game gets a bit janky. Because people get Fultoned through buildings. This guy I've got to take out. Yeah, okay. Right, so my gun's getting pretty slim now. And by pretty slim, I mean pretty low on ammo. So I need to wait for the other guy to turn his back, go over there, and then I can take this guy out with the stun rod and then Fulton him, and then I'll probably just take that guy out, because I've run out of Fulton recovery after one more guy. I don't see any. Don't see anything that I would want more from any one guard. Okay. There it is. Right, I need to get behind him.
Enemies close.
Sugar.
By.
Okay.
They spotted you. Get out of there.
Okay. Luckily, it's just him, and I ballsed up on the last enemy. But now you see, I've got the
good
alert phase and the stuff.
They're still looking, though.
But
they'll
luckily, no one called
it
in. No one called it in, so no one's actually going to be coming this way. I will Fulton him out because he's in a pretty obvious place. I feel like there's going to be a boss somehow. Or something weird's going to happen. Oh no, maybe not. Maybe you just go up into that attic. Okay, skip, because we don't need to see this crap. We want to see as much of the game as possible. Oh yeah, now you've got this big beast. Attack! So this is like the first time Snake's really seeing big kind of floating enemies, UAVs that like you'd see on Big Shell. And whoa, yeah, there's the big AI thing. Bam! Oh, what? Dodge.
Es un hombre nuevo, an unmanned weapon, a robot.
No, he won't survive the fall.
Out of my way!
And that's where Chico and Paz come in. They're prominent characters, at least in Ground Zeroes. They are prominent characters. Chico, I think, will feature at least. What the hell's it called? The Phantom Pain. My brain is just useless today. Extracted 8 soldiers. And got the... So that was a pistol.
Snake.
That I got the specs for. Skip that. And, yeah. So, what we might now have time for... Yes, we've got a report from Mother Base. Got a report from the R&D team, so we'll head back and say hi to them. See what they've got, because they might now have a improved Mark 22. Yep, there we go. So the rounds take effect after a period of time. Suppressed durability has been increased. We've got that, and that, and that. So, you know, stuff picks up pretty quickly. We do want to go into Mother Base just to check these guys out. Yeah, so there's... Whoa. See, now this guy I picked up, Axolotl, is an incredible R&D specialist. Look at this guy just screaming away. We'll stick him in the R&D unit. Stick him... Oh, crap. See, now I need to... Yeah, him I need to reassign to the R&D unit. He's an R&D man. So now I can improve that. So the higher level your R&D team, the... Well, you know, the better stuff you can do. These guys I'm going to leave. You do... Oh, hang on. No, I've got some good combat units. Combat unit man. So you do eventually get to the point where people are like, hey, no one's cooking food and stuff like that. So you unlock the other bits. Like, you know, people get sick, you need medicine. And that stuff unlocks gradually as it goes along. So now I've got any extra ops? Yeah, I've got like three of these. So I've got target practice there, target score, and I've done Fulton recovery. So we can do Pursue Amanda, which is another mission. And it kind of just goes goes off from there, really. So I think I'm going to leave it there because I don't want to get too much into it and spoil it for you. But that's basically it, to give you an overview. If you can't afford maybe the Phantom Pain, this is a great place to start. It's got all that good stuff. It's got base management. You don't build that base that you're seeing there. It kind of evolves as you get more units, and that's as the game goes on. You can go back and redo missions and still bring more people in, and you could basically just have like millions of people in your base. You can do co-op. Like I said, you can do versus ops, which is online competitive, I believe. I don't know if it's in the similar style. I played a lot of... Yeah, I'm not sure. I'll go back from that. I played a lot of Portable Ops Online, which was basically Team Deathmatch with Metal Gear style. So you were like crouching and hiding and stuff in small corners and just basically taking people out. You had your mother base working on lots of equipment so you could take that into multiplayer and blast the crap out of people, which is what the PvP-ish mode... FOB forward operation bases is about in the Phantom Pain. But anyway, I've given you an overview of everything here in Mother Base of in Peace Walker. So, like I say, we'll probably do a playthrough over on my channel, Jamie's, which I can put a link in the description to. There's not a playthrough going on there yet at the moment because I've already got quite a lot going on, but in the future, depending, I might do a playthrough, might just live stream it, because it's quite easy to just kind of talk through and all that kind of stuff. But anyway, let me know what you think of the game in the comments. Thank you to everyone who's been subscribing so far. We've had to take a break from doing videos for Clipping Error, because I've been doing Let's Play stuff on my other channel, and it's been a bit of a nightmare getting stuff sorted, but we're getting back on track, kind of. So I'm going to try and do at least one a week. Hopefully, one a week. I have just moved house. There's a lot going on. Thank you for bearing with me. I've had more subscribers going on even doing nothing, which kind of shows me you guys appreciate my content, which really I like. So thank you for that. And just bear with me. Keep liking videos, keep watching them, and I'll just bring you more stuff. Roll on Ground Zeroes. And you didn't hear it here, but Mad Max. So, on that bombshell, I will see you later next time. Love you. Bye.